video, we are going to see about the algorithm of merge-sort technique with an example in detail. So now, what is merge-sort about? Merge-sort is nothing but a sorting technique for sort an array of random elements. The important note of this sorting technique is that it uses divide and conquer strategy. So the main advantages of merge-sort are it is more efficient and time-consuming. So now let's get into the algorithm and see how it works. For that algorithm, merge sort of an array A with an elements 0 to n minus 1. To start with the algorithm, I must check for the number of elements in an array. That is, if n is greater than 1, it means that array A should contain two or more elements so that only sorting can be made possible. If this condition is true, it starts with dividing the A array into its components. That is, we should divide the A array into two equal halves and copy it into B and C, which is that copy A 0 to floor of n by 2 minus 1 to B 0 to floor of n by 2 minus 1. This is what the first half of A array is copied to B array. Likewise, the rest of the elements in the A array is copied to the C array, which goes like this: copy A floor of n minus n floor of n by 2 to n minus 1 to C 0 to C of n by 2 minus 1. Second half of A elements. These two steps are recursively done until you get all the elements in the array are individually separated. So for that, I'm calling the merge sort function recursively until I get all the elements to be separated individually. So with this, we have completed with dividing the A array into its individual elements. Now we are starting with how the merging and sorting technique works. For that, I am defining a method called merge B, C, A, which is that again defined as algorithm of merging technique. Algorithm of merge B, C, A. Here, in this algorithm, it takes B and C as input and combine together to form a sorted A array, which is our output. So, for this, since it includes three arrays, we are declaring three pointers, which is I is equals to 0, J is equal to 0, and K is equals to 0. These three pointers are used to point over the indexes of A, B, C and A array respectively. So now, while I is less than P and J is less than Q, which is that an array B and C should contain some elements. So if this while condition is true, we should do sorting and merging technique, which goes like this. If b of I less than equals to c of j, then copy the b content to the a array, which is that consider two arrays b and c with some elements. This is the array b and this is the array c. So the b array contains some elements like 2, 3, 1, and c array contains some elements like 5, 4, 5, and 6. So now the merge technique works in this way, which is how the b the pointer I is pointing towards the first indices of b initially. Likewise, the pointer j is pointing towards the first indices or first element of c initially. Since the b and c array contain some elements, the while loop condition is true, and hence we are checking for if condition, that is b of I, the element I pointing to, is should be less than or equal to the element pointed by the j. So here the condition is true, hence we are moving this element which is pointed by I, this element which is pointed by I, to the A array, like 2, and the rest will be. And hence, that is, we are moving the element which is pointed by I to the A array, and hence we are incrementing I. To check for the next element. Likewise, if this condition is false, that is the b of I is less than equals to c of j, for instance, if the array was like this 5, 3, 2 and c 1, 4, 7. Here the element I pointing to is greater than the element j pointing to. Hence, we should copy the element j pointing to, that is 1, to the array A. And we should just increment the j to compare with the next element. So now for this condition, we are copying this element c to A array, which goes like this. A of k should contain c of j, and j pointer has to be incremented for comparing the next element. And then the k pointer has to be incremented so that the next element after comparing can accommodate the next indices of A array. For that, I am incrementing k is equals to k plus 1. So then, if I is equals to p, if the total number of elements in the b array is all copied to the a, but then g still we have some elements in the c array, we should copy the rest of the elements in the c array directly to the a array. For that, I am including copy c of j q minus 1 to a of k p plus q minus 1. Else, if in this case, if j gets computed, that is c elements, all the c elements in the array are gets stored in the a, but still some of the a, b array elements are not yet. For that, I have to copy the rest of the b elements in the array after the c elements. For that, I am writing copy else copy b of I to p minus 1 to a of k p plus 1 minus 1. So this is recursively done until we get an sorted array. This is how algorithm of merge sort works. Now let's get on to compute what is the time complexity of merge sort. For that, time complexity of merge sort. F- for that, I'm defining an equation which is that t of n is equals to 2 t of n by 2 plus n. Here in this equation, this part says about the dividing strategy what we have done before, and this n defines the merging process. Hence the equation of merge sort flows like this, which is t of n is equal to 2 into t of n by 2 plus n. So now we are to compute the time complexity, we use Master's theorem, which includes comparing A with B power. We should check the given equation with the general equation. The general equation goes this way. T of n is equals to A T of n by B plus F of n. So with comparing the equation with the general equation, we conclude A is equal to 2, B is equal to 2, and D is equals to 1. D, which is the power of n. Here in the equation, the power is 1. So therefore, D is equal to 1. Then we should compare A with B power D. Here A is equals to 2 and B power D is equals to 2 power 1, which is equals to 2. Hence, we can conclude that A is equals to B power D using Master's theorem. Thus, the time complexity of merge sort is T of n belongs to big theta of n log n.
Let us take an example for merge sort. Now, an unsorted array of elements are taken 8, 1, 4, 8, 9, 5, 3, 1, 3, 5. Consider this as A, array A. Now, this is such that the array is split into two equal halves. As this contains... Now, check for entries here. Here, n is equal to 10. Now, split this array into two equal halves. Consider this as B array and this as C array. As the algorithm says, the B array is splitted in such a way that it contains floor of n by 2 number of elements is given into one array and the rest is given to another array. The same procedure is followed for C array. Here it is divided into two. It is divided into two. And here 5, 3, then 1, 3, 5. Continue the same procedure for these four arrays. Here 8 and 1. Split this into 2 such that 4 and 8. 9. The same procedure is followed here. 5, 3, and here it is divided into 2, 3, 5. Now continue the same until we get separated individual sorted elements. 8, 1, 4. Divide this into 2, 8 and 9. Here 5, 3, 1. Divide this into 2, 3, 5. Now, we separated each and every individual elements of array A. Here, next, the merge and sort technique starts. Now, we should first merge 8 and 1. As we divide 8 and 1 here, we should merge... Now we should merge in sorted array 1 and 8. Then we should merge 8 and 9. In sorted order. Now here 8 and 9. Then the 4 should be repeated here. We should not merge 4 and 1 or 4 and 8. The same procedure is followed here. Here 5 and 3 is merged in sorted way. Here 3, 5 and here 3, 5, 1 is repeated here. Now merge 4 and 8, 9. Name this as B and this as C. Merge and sort these two arrays such a way we get 4, 8, 9. Repeat this array. The same is followed here. Here 1, 3, 5 is merged in sorted way. Then 3, 5 is repeated here. Name this is B and this is C. Here B and C. Now sort these, submerge and sort these two arrays. Now we get 1, 4, 8, 8, 9. Here one, three, three, 5, 5. Now consider this is B and this is C. Finally merge and sort the following arrays. Now we get 1, 3, 3, 4, 5, 5, 8, 8, 9.
This is the
sorted array. This is the
sorted array.
Of A. This is how the merge sort works. Thank you for listening. Yes.